Always tempting. Give us a follow if you see it. And we can follow with a Jesus. Always tempting. Is that my channel?
Hey, happy Father's Day. I hope you're feeling blessed and refreshed. I'm back again with another one. And today, y'all, we are making those chili dogs. Chili dogs. So we just gonna jump right into it. I'm gonna chit-chat with y'all for a minute. And I hope that you enjoyed this video. I got some cheesy-filled hot dogs. They were on sale in my local Walmart. And I just got those, opened them up, thrown them in a pan, put them in the oven on 350 for as long as it takes me to make the entire meal. So the really good thing about cooking big meals for me is that I use half the meat now and half the meat tomorrow. So in this case, I've already used half of this meat for another meal. So I'm gonna just go ahead and use this other half of the meat for the chili. So what's gonna happen is I'm gonna have so much chili left over that we're gonna make another meal tomorrow. So I'm interested to know if you have any ideas. Link it down below or comment down below and let me know, what do you think tomorrow's meal is gonna be using our chili from today? Okay, so now that I got the meat in the pan, I'm going in with my favorite meat masher. I got this one from Amazon. I can link it down below for y'all. I think this works a lot better than a spoon or even a spatula. I think it was like $11.99 or so on Amazon. It was definitely worth it. So now I'm going to go ahead and season my meat. What I really like about this meal is that it's only, what, about 3 or 4 ingredients and maybe about 30 or 35 minutes and it's done. Super easy. You can have it for lunch one day. I really enjoy it because we don't have to use the oven. It's really good for summertime. In this case, on this day, we are gonna toast our buns in the oven and make like garlic buns. But of course, as anything else, you can make it the way you like. So now I'm gonna go ahead and put the chili seasoning on top of the salt and pepper that I put in there. I think I use Accent as well. I really like Accent because it just brings out the flavors in whatever you're cooking. It doesn't make things too salty or too seasoned or anything. So yeah, comment down below and let me know if you guys like to use Accent or not. I like to use beef broth. That's my secret in making ground beef or grounding up my beef, is to use beef broth. It just gives it a really good flavor and a really good consistency. Have you ever made hamburger meat and it came out really burnt in some pieces? That is probably the reason why I would use a little bit of beef broth. Try that. Let me know what you think. So thank you guys so much for being here so far. I really appreciate you. You could be anywhere else, but you chose to be here with me, and I will always be grateful. Don't forget to go ahead and hit the like button, and if you're not subscribed, go ahead and subscribe. It's a whole vibe. I am always looking for new ideas of recipes or things to make, so if you got anything that you want to see, go ahead and drop a comment down below. I really enjoy engaging with you guys in the comments. So as always, don't forget to comment after the premiere, because the live chat is not always saved. I hope that you guys are enjoying your Father's Day. Shout out to all the fathers, all the uncle fathers, all the brother fathers, all the grandfather fathers, and all the father fathers. All the single mothers who are fathers, and all the aunties and grandmas who have to be fathers too. Yeah, no, I had to take it to the extreme. Let's get back into this cooking thing. Okay, so now after we done had it covered for a minute, we went over there and we washed up our dirty dishes and cleaned off our table and carrying on. We are back and the meat is finally done, y'all. So as you can see, I went ahead and drained it already and I'm now back. I'm gonna go ahead and turn that fire off and I'm gonna go ahead and get my tomato sauce and my beans and everything and pour them up in there. I like to use 1 can of tomato sauce and 2 cans of beans. But as always, you know, use your own judgment, yo. Based on what you like and what your family likes. We like to eat a lot of beans. Beans, good for your heart. The more you eat them, the more you fart. So yeah, anyway, there's my beans, a great value, cheap as can. You could use any kind of beans you want. I feel like some things I can substitute and get the cheaper brand, and some things you have to stick to the real brand. Okay, now mix it up good, put the top back on it, turn the oven on low, and let it sit. Oh yeah, I forgot my garlic. I like to sneak garlic in wherever I can. It's good for high blood sugar as well as high blood pressure. Just a teaspoon a day will make a greater difference. All right, so now we got that covered and going. There are my hot dog buns, and I'm gonna take them out and I'm gonna put them in my little pan over here so that we can put them in the oven. And what I like to do as well is sometimes we'll make them garlic flavored garlic buns. So I'm gonna melt a little bit of butter in my coffee cup. You can use whatever you use to melt butter, or you can melt it on the stove or in the microwave, however you do. And then when that's done, I'm gonna put a little bit of garlic in there as well, and I'm gonna mix it up, and then I'm gonna spread it on top of my buns. Then I'm gonna go ahead and put them in the oven on 350 for about 10 minutes, just enough time to make them toasty, a little bit of crunch, but not burnt. So I'm curious, comment down below, let me know, do you do it the same way as I do? Do you toast the buns in the oven, or do you go for what you know and just use them right out the package? Okay, so at this point the hot dogs are done, and yeah, I forgot I put those in the oven as well. Like I said, this day wasn't very hot, so we were able to do that. But you could maybe make the hot dogs on the grill, or you could boil them, however you prefer. Now, I always like to get into how much it costs for me to make a meal like this. The buns were about $2.38. The small roll of hamburger meat was about $3.78. And then I had two cans of chili beans, and I think they were like a dollar a piece. And then that tomato sauce that I had was like 38 cents. And then I had a pack of chili seasoning, which was a dollar. So if you add everything up, you're looking at less than $20. Oh, plus the hot dogs. A lot of times you can find them on sale, especially in the summer. But for me, this time, this pack of hot dogs was $1.78. So, oh, and then the cheese, and then we put onions on top. So just depending on your preferences, you're looking at $20 or less for a meal like this that gives you 8 hot dogs. And for us, that's perfect. We're just feeding a family of 4, but you can always double this recipe and you're still looking at $30 or less to make a meal for the whole family. So that makes me wonder if y'all want to see more videos like this where I explain how much it costs for me to make a meal, or would y'all prefer me to just shut up and show y'all how to make the meal? Hey, you're still here. I see you. Thank you so much. If you haven't already, smash the like button and share me out. So at this point, I'm going to go ahead and pull out my condiments. I got the triple cheddar, shredded cheese, the mustard, and the ketchup. And I got some diced up onions to put on top. But of course, you can use whatever toppings you like. Let me know what toppings y'all gonna put on y'all chili dogs. So I'm gonna go ahead and take my bowl, and I'm gonna pour my done chili on up in there. I like to try to reduce the pots and pans as much as I can by putting stuff in bowls and washing stuff as I cook. It just makes things easier for me, because as you know, once you sit down, it's over with. There is our chili, y'all. Don't it just look so good? Making me hungry all over again. Anyway, we've done enough talking, y'all. It's time to go ahead and plate it. Everybody is picky. Everybody likes theirs differently. Nene got ketchup, mustard, and onions this time with no cheese. ZZ had just ketchup and mustard. No onions, no cheese. And I want it all. When I tell you it wasn't no leftovers, it wasn't no leftovers. Most of the time, I try to cook so that there are no leftovers. But sometimes, if there are, we'll eat them for lunch the next day. So there are my toasted buns with my Dunn hot dogs. There's my chili going on top. Ain't that just so pretty? Presentation is everything. Let me tell you, it's all going to the same place, but presentation is everything. So I'm going to go ahead and put my shredded cheese on top. Just a little bit of cheese for me. I don't need too much. Don't that just look so good? Now wait till we add the onions. Don't forget the ketchup and mustard if you prefer. I forgot about relish. But anyway, there it is, y'all. It's over. That's it. That's all. Everybody is eating. Everybody is enjoying it. Hi, Nene. And ZZ said, hi. Thumbs up. Thumbs up if it's good. You gotta go in for another bite. Thumbs up if it's good. That's it. That's all, y'all. I'm hot. I'm sweating. But you know it wouldn't be right if I didn't taste it. That was good. I appreciate y'all again for being here. And as always, remember, be true to yourself. Because if you're not true to yourself, you can't be true to nobody else. Bye-bye.